Hello, welcome to Healing Wounds. I'm here with Pastor Kathleen Harris, can call you Pastor, on today. And today we will be discussing the heart.
Yeah, amen. Because, you know, like healing, we know healing our hearts, you know. And a lot of times people don't know how to heal their hearts.
That's true.
And we cannot heal our own hearts, you know. And we are becoming from, like, healing a damaged heart. You know, healing a damaged heart. And when we are exposed to different things.
Yes.
And our heart get wounded. Oh, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, yes,
and, I know. And then it's like, then it goes to our head, you know. Mm. But our hearts gets wounded,
okay.
You know, and we carry it there,
yes.
More than our head, you okay. Know what I'm saying? So that's why we're going to talk about, you know, healing hearts,
okay.
You know, healing our hearts today. Amen?
Amen.
So let's start. We're going to be looking at ourself when healing hearts, you know,
okay.
Healing your heart. And you have so many, people have so many questions, they don't know where to begin, how to ask for the healing.
Yes.
So when you have your heart is wounded,
mm-hmm.
You know, how do we do heal? You know, do we give it to God or do we try to work something out?
Wow, that's a good question. That's a good question. Because usually when we're hurting, we don't even think to really give it to God.
Mm-hmm.
That's the thing that we should do,
mm-hmm.
But we kind of bask in it,
mm-hmm.
And then it goes over into more.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, if I have unresolved hurt in my heart,
mm-hmm.
And I don't deal with it,
mm-hmm.
Then it goes to bitterness.
Mm-hmm.
Then from bitterness it goes on and on,
mm-hmm.
And on.
Mm-hmm.
But I can see why David said in Psalms 51,
mm-hmm.
And created in 17, created me a clean heart,
heart,
you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, give
mm-hmm.
me a broken heart,
mm-hmm.
Because all of that hurt will harden our hearts.
Mm-hmm. See, a lot of times, see, we push it, mm-hmm. And we push it, and we push it down until we can't push it down anymore. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
When I'm saying pushing it down, that's why it cannot, our wounds be pushed down so much that sooner or later it's going to come out some kind of way.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? It's going to come out some kind of way.
Yes.
That our heart is, I was looking at a heart, you
yeah,
know,
okay.
And I should have brought a picture.
Yes.
You know, looking at a heart, and the heart is like our hand.
Yes.
And it's shaped like our hand. Because it goes that way and it goes all the way down.
Mm-hmm.
And a part has two parts,
mm-hmm.
To it, and have the vessels, you
yes.
Know, pumping. Our heart pumps 100,000 times a day.
Oh, wow.
You know?
Yes.
And I say, wow, that's a lot.
It is. It
that's
really
a lot.
Is.
if we lose one beat,
yes.
You know, it causes problems.
Yes.
And that's why we want to heal our hearts.
Because
yes. They cause so much
yes.
Disease.
Yes.
So much hurt, confusion, healing your heart, you know. So we're going to talk, going to read a scripture. Amen. Matthew 8:17.
Okay. That it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself took our infirmities and bare our sickness.
Mm-hmm. See, you know, we cannot heal ourselves, you know. What it says?
That Jesus, he took our infirmities,
mm-hmm.
And bare our sickness.
Mm-hmm. And why do we hold on to our sickness? So that's why the heart is strenuous, you
yes.
Know. How can that wound be healed, you know? Because we take on so much.
Yes.
We take on yes. So much. So how can it be healed?
We have to go to God. We have to go to his word.
Mm-hmm.
We have to go to God. And because a lot of times we'll be hurting and we get so used to hurting,
mm-hmm.
That feeling to that we don't realize we're hurting.
Mm-hmm. That's true. That's true.
And so then when somebody may come to you and say, you know, the Lord showed me that you got a lot of hurt in your
mm-hmm.
Heart. No, I don't.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't.
So we already demonstrated. We show the action. And then later on, we feel it.
Yes.
We feel it.
That's why we have these sicknesses in our bodies, you know, with our colons, with our mm-hmm. heart. If we sin, weakens the heart, where the yes. heart is a muscle and it's mm-hmm. tight
yes.
like this, and mm-hmm. it beats like. Mm-hmm. But when it gets weakened, it's hard to pump that blood through that mm-hmm. body. We're tired, mm-hmm. we're sleepy, mm-hmm. we don't have any energy, mm-hmm. and we can't serve God like that.
Sure enough, you can't, you know. So we have to be, that's why he have to heal our wounds.
Amen.
You know.
Amen.
And so let's try to get healed of your broken heart.
Yes.
You know.
Yes.
And let's read Romans 8:26, 27. Because you know, this like our healing our heart is really serious. Because once the heart is gone, it's mm. gone. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, no
it's
life.
Gone. No life. No life. And that's why you have your heart has, you done beat the heart up so much,
yes.
then it's be like jelly.
Jelly, yeah.
And
mush.
It's just mush, you know. So we want to heal our heart so it won't get mush.
Mush,
you know?
That's amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. Romans 8:26, likewise, the Spirit has helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought, mm-hmm. but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered.
Yes.
And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God.
Mm-hmm. You know, the will of God tells us we have to forgive.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to forgive ourselves.
Yes.
And as we be wounded, is that heart takes on that thing.
Oh, it's okay. When we get most like if I took on an offense,
mm-hmm.
and I don't release it.
Mm-mm.
And releasing it, meaning running to God. Lord, mm-hmm. they hurt me. Lord, I don't feel it was fair. Mm-hmm. Just giving it to him wholeheartedly.
Yes.
And allow him to deal with me. Mm-hmm. And then take that hurt.
Mm-hmm.
You know, take
mm-hmm.
it. Mm-hmm. If I don't do that, then that's the process of that. I began to become offensive.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you may say something. What? I didn't do that. Mm-hmm. What?
Yes.
I take on that in the form of my heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's something.
Mm-hmm. And we do it unaware.
Yes.
You know, unaware.
Yes.
Are we doing this, you know?
Yes.
So, you know, and that's why he said renew our spirit
right.
daily.
Right.
Our mind.
Our mind, yes.
And
yes.
so that we can catch it.
Yeah, so we have to be open.
We have to be open.
We have to be, man.
Yeah, we have to be open so that we can receive the healing for our heart.
Right. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Amen.
Even though we don't see, may not see that hurt,
mm-hmm.
don't mean we don't have it.
Yes, right. That's right. Yes, right.
That's what I learned, you know.
Yeah, because a lot of times we cover up.
Yes.
And
yes.
we all only cover up so much.
Much, yeah.
You know,
yes.
how long can we cover up for the hurt? For our hearts,
right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right. Mm-hmm. And it's like that's the hardest thing to do. Something happens, we get hurt. Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm all right. Mm-hmm. I'm all right. I'm all right. No, and we're not all right.
Mm-hmm.
We're hurting on the inside.
Amen. Amen.
Would admit that,
we walk around with all this stuff, and all of a sudden we find ourselves sick, or whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Yes. Getting headaches.
Mm-hmm.
Getting pains
mm-hmm.
on my hip,
mm-hmm.
on my knee,
mm-hmm.
on my, you know.
Yes.
Different parts of our body.
Mm-hmm. Amen, amen, amen. So that's why we're going to have to really, really be careful about what we receive in our hearts.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, Lord, yes. Yes.
So as we begin to do that, we'll begin to see a whole new picture, a new likeness in him, you know, and we feel better because we getting our wounds
healed,
taken care of.
Yes,
you know?
Yes.
You know?
And you feel so much lighter, like you was carrying a weight.
Mm-hmm. We do, because we're not made to carry that.
Right.
We are not made to carry that. Yes. And that's why he said, give me your, what, cares.
Cares. Yeah.
Cast your cares on who?
Yeah.
Him.
Yeah. All of them. The little ones that we say, oh, I'm all right.
Yes.
I'm all right.
Yes. And a lot of times, the little ones, the other one really hurts.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so we got to begin to cast our cares on him.
Yes.
You know, as we looking at different things, you know.
Yes.
And our sickness is dormant in there.
Yes.
So we're going to have to heal that. You know, we have to get a foundation.
Okay.
You know, the foundation, how to release our heart. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And then as we're doing that, we could get healed from it, you know, from that. And do you have anything else, like, on your mind that with the healing process, like your heart, you know? So as we enter in different objects, you know, the evil.
The evil, mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. That's
the
evil. Big one.
Yes. And
that's
I think that's
one.
Coming from where? That is like we hold evil in
yeah.
our hearts, you know?
We do. Mm-hmm. Revenge, retaliation, mm-hmm. when someone do something to us and we don't get it resolved. We don't release it mm-hmm. right away. Mm-hmm. That it's an opening for the enemy to start saying, to start counseling you.
Mm-hmm.
And that wasn't right. That wasn't mm-hmm. fair.
Yep. So it's time out. Christians, time out for faking.
That's true.
So we want to heal
That's
your
true.
Wounds, okay?
That's true.
We have many wounds that need to
be
healed.
And a lot of Christians go around, I'm all right, I'm saved, I'm sanctified. Oh, that's under the blood, that's mm-hmm. this, that's that.
Yes, yes.
And everybody see the hurt.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Everybody can feel it walking mm-hmm. by them.
Except us.
Right. Except mm-hmm. the person that, you know, mm-hmm. that's in that state. Because
yes.
I've been in that state,
mm-hmm.
you know, and mm-hmm. thinking it was one thing. And come, the Lord come show me, nope. Years
yes.
ago, way back here,
mm-hmm.
this happened.
Mm-hmm.
And you and that person never discussed it.
Mm-hmm.
You went on your way, they mm-hmm. went on their way.
Mm-hmm.
But that thing was festering.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And
yes.
get to the point where, oh, I can't mm-hmm. stand that person. Oh,
mm-hmm.
I can't. I don't want to hear a voice.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want, you know what
mm-hmm.
I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And then when, as I confessed, was talking to my leaders,
mm-hmm.
some stuff, you know, I confessed how I felt mm-hmm. about this certain person.
Mm-hmm.
And later on, the Lord began to deal with me.
Mm-hmm.
He says, not what you think.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then took me back.
Okay.
Took me back to something that happened mm-hmm. years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Years
yes.
ago.
And a lot of times you see when our heart get wounded, and it's not just that first one.
Mm-hmm.
It's way back there.
Mm-hmm.
And then it connected
to
you
it.
See, you know what I'm saying?
But your focus, because mm-hmm. you can identify with
mm-hmm.
that one.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
mm-hmm.
yes. Studying, like the enemy, he gives
yeah.
us the lesser.
Yes. Yeah.
So you want to get the biggie.
Make
you know what I'm
right,
saying?
Right.
So that you can still be messed up.
Right.
You know,
you
in
throw
your
throw you
heart.
A crumb
yes.
and here you got a big old cake.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
So
saying?
We want to get it. You
yes,
know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So doing so, you know, like getting to that root of our, you know, subject
yes.
our being.
Yes.
And a hurt in there, you
and
know.
That heart, yes.
So let's turn to Matthew. Let's see what Matthew 7:16 says. You know, so we have to be teachable. You know what I'm saying? And for to really, Matthew 7:16.
Okay.
We have to be teachable.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
so that we can be healed of this, and we have to be learneth. You know,
yeah.
when I say teachable, what do you? When I say teachable, what do you think about?
Openness.
Open.
Yeah, I mm-hmm. have to be open. I can't put up walls.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
I gotta let them down.
Mm-hmm.
I just gotta let it down and let the allow the word to come in.
Mm-hmm.
Or what you're saying to come in, and allow give the Holy Spirit time to touch my understanding.
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes we can be caught up in that wasn't right, that's
mm-hmm.
unfair. Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. I hear you, but. I hear you, but.
Yes.
But as we allow the Holy Spirit mm-hmm. and keep bringing them words back, and He keep working on us and working mm-hmm. on us, and then He'll show you that truth. Mm-hmm. You know.
Mm-hmm. So it comes connected together, being teachable and learner.
Yeah, because you know. If I'm not teachable, mm-hmm. how am I gonna learn?
That's right.
I can't.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. Yes. And I found out, I know, for example, that you can't learn something that what you don't have.
Mm.
So that's why you have to be teachable. And then you have to be willing.
Yeah, because nobody knows it all.
Yes.
Some people want to come across like they do.
Oh,
but
yes.
They don't.
Yes, amen, amen, amen,
you
amen.
Know, and some people will look at you and watch you and hear certain things that mm-hmm. you say and mm-hmm. this and that, and then call you up with a word.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not God.
Mm-hmm.
It's their word.
Mm-hmm.
But they'll say it's God's word.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So we're going to have to really change and flip it over.
Yeah.
You know, to let them and ourselves know, no, it's not God.
God, yeah.
You know, it's
yes.
not God.
Yes.
So we need to wait so that we could be healed and manifest in our spirit
right.
on this.
And then the thing I'm finding out too, that even in the waiting and as allowing God to deal with me, mm-hmm. to pray for the person.
Amen.
To
Amen.
Really sincerely pray for that person because they think they're right.
Amen.
I mean, mm-hmm. you mm-hmm. know what I'm mm-hmm. saying?
So as we praying, you know, we praying mm-hmm. for that person.
Right.
So we should be praying like, Lord, show them.
Yep. That's
set
it.
Set them free.
That's it. You know. Deliver them, Lord mm-hmm. God.
Set them free. So that, and so they could be willing. You know, we got to be willing.
Yes, we do. We really do. And I even, in the process, the young man that shot my son, mm-hmm. I'm praying more for him,
mm-hmm.
for his salvation,
mm-hmm.
you know. And
see, that's healing, and that's your wound. You know what I'm
yeah,
saying?
Yeah.
Because that wounds you,
mm-hmm.
and all of a sudden, what you see after that is still wounded.
Wounded. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to be healed, and plus the person got to be healed too.
Too. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Amen.
Amen.
So you know, it's a mixture.
Yeah, it is.
You know?
It is, and it takes time.
Mm-hmm.
It takes time. People will say, oh, I got prayer. Oh, I'm healed from that. I'm mm-hmm. healed from that. But depending on how long,
mm-hmm.
how long you held that hurt.
In your heart.
In your heart.
Mm-hmm.
And to the time that you really recognize
mm-hmm.
and accept, oh, my God, it's there.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, I'm sorry I sinned against you, myself, blah, blah, blah,
mm-hmm.
blah.
Mm-hmm.
And it takes time because
right.
we don't readily receive that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That I'm hurting.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a process.
Mm-hmm. You know, we hurt daily.
Yes,
you know,
yes, yes.
Because our feelings, he says, don't go by feelings.
Feelings.
You know.
But we do.
But we do.
Yeah.
We go by feelings.
Yep.
And we need to go by his spirit. You know. And that we're human. And we need to get back to the basics.
Six.
You know
yes.
what I'm saying?
Yes.
And because he didn't make us that way.
No.
You know.
No, he didn't.
So the former years
no, he didn't.
Over when Adam and Eve. You know
yes.
what I'm saying?
Yes,
and
yes,
you know
yes,
something?
Yes, yes, yes.
I was just thinking, I'm just throwing this out.
Uh-huh.
I just was thinking about Adam and Eve.
Yeah.
You know, Eve was wounded.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Being deceived.
Yeah.
And she had a broken heart.
Heart yeah.
And then also, then she added Eve.
Adam
into that mm-hmm. hurt, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Being deceived,
yeah.
you know, about, you know, the tree.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm not going to go a long
yeah.
story on
right,
that.
Right, right,
but,
right.
But, you know,
right.
and I think that's when our deceased came in.
Yes.
You know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Deception. Yep.
Deception.
Yes, it did.
Deception.
Yes, it did. Yes,
and
it did.
I think
did.
We had a scripture on that deception.
Did you?
Yeah. I guess we'll get it. But you know, we be deceived.
Yes.
That's why our heart be always, you know, like getting broken.
Broken, yeah.
And everything. So we want to have to learn how to be in the will of God. So yes. Our heart will stay like it's supposed to be.
Yes, amen. Yes, yes, yes.
Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Where are we at? You said.
Okay, and then now we have, let's look at Romans 6, 1.
Romans.
I didn't give you that one. You know, like our hearts is secret. Wicked,
mm-hmm.
And like the word says, we don't know our own heart.
No,
you know, and people always say they know their heart.
Oh yeah. Oh God, know my heart.
I he look know. At them, and I, you know,
but sin is still sin.
Yeah, I just stop right there. I don't go any further, you know, because yes. it's not to argue with them
yes,
or
yes.
to show them.
Yeah.
But God, I just stop yes. and just let. Oop,
oop, yeah.
Oop. Let God deal with their broken yes. heart, you know, yeah. because their heart is broken. You know.
Yeah.
So this is why, you know, you need to have your heart healed. You know.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. You said 6:1?
Yes.
Okay. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound?
Let's do another thing.
God forbid. Mm-hmm. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein.
Mm-hmm. See, that's me. If we are dying to
right.
God, our heart should be healed.
Yes.
You know what I'm yes. saying? It should be healed. And we won't have all these diseases that
yes.
come against us. And yes, look, yes, listen yes. to this. And you cannot hurt me.
Right.
You know?
Right.
You know, you cannot hurt me,
right?
Because we have Jesus.
Right.
As we get learneth and study
yeah.
and that will grow and get
yeah.
thicker.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
It'll get
yes.
thicker.
Amen.
And like when I was coming up, and I'm sure when you was coming
uh-huh.
up, that they would say sticks and bones will break my bones
yeah.
and names will never harm.
Yeah.
They need to change that.
That
names
do hurt.
Words do hurt. You know
very
what I'm
much.
Saying?
Yes.
You know, it does hurt. And I think they say that so they can
justify
themselves.
Mm-hmm.
But hey, you still got to get that wound fixed.
That's right. You still got to get that hurt
mm-hmm.
taken care of.
Yes.
We do.
So I think you have some other scripture.
Oh, did we do Romans? No, you did Romans 8:26. Oh, Matthew 15, mm-hmm. is that 15:19?
Mm-hmm.
Let me see here.
You know, just like for us healing that hurt people.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So we need to learn how to operate in our hearts so
yes.
it could be healed. So that we don't have any damage,
yes.
so we could damage others.
That's right. Because mm-hmm. if you don't realize you're hurting, and you're angry all the time,
mm-hmm.
and you go around hurting other people,
mm-hmm.
you know, and you don't, and, oh, that's just me. That's just mm-hmm. me. It's their fault because they did this or
mm-hmm.
they said or they, but it still goes back to your hurt.
Yes.
The hurt
yes,
in your heart.
Yes, 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 yes.
And
we supposed to love.
Amen. All
no,
the time.
Love.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Out of the heart. We got here Matthew 15:19. For out of the heart proceed the evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornication, thefts, false witnesses, blasphemies. These are the things which defile a man. But to eat with unwashed hands defile of not a man.
Mm-hmm.
So it's the inside.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why the word tells us someplace in another verse that God looks upon the heart.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because the heart entails all of the our intellect, mm-hmm. our emotions,
mm-hmm.
all of that together.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's wounded, it can't operate the way he ordained for it
mm-hmm.
to operate.
Mm-hmm.
We can't love out of, he said, out of the heart comes the issues of
mm-hmm,
life.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So,
yes,
we have to get our heart healed.
Yes, we do. Because like that first one, what it says.
We got here, for out of the heart proceed of evil thoughts.
Evil.
Evil is
know,
sin.
Evil, you know, as we think it.
Yeah.
you know.
Yeah, as a man thinketh in his heart, mm-hmm. so is he.
Mm-hmm. And so, and that's tear your heart.
Oh.
You know, we have different
parts.
We put
a lot of stuff on these hearts.
And veils.
Yeah.
And that's why you have early strokes.
Yeah.
Yep. Heart attacks,
yes.
Premature.
Sure. Yes.
You know, you're seeing yes. younger generation it's now yeah. is dying from this
yes.
and being afflicted
right.
right now, you yes. know, just because they have not healed their wounded
yeah.
heart. You know what I'm saying? Yes.
And you know, unforgiveness is a big one too.
Oh, yes.
People
unforgiveness.
People no, they did this to me. Mm-hmm. They're wrong. Mm-hmm. And that weakens the heart too.
It weakens the heart.
It really does.
And that's one of the commands, forgive.
Forgive, you gotta forgive.
You know, we've yeah. got to go. Because, you know, if you do not forgive, you know you're gonna come up to some problems,
right.
you know? And then God will not forgive
you.
You know?
Right.
And then why you want God to forgive you if you don't forgive others,
right.
you know?
So if we're in an unforgiving state, then mm-hmm. we in sin.
Mm-hmm. Yes. We in this country,
yes.
unforgiveness.
Yeah.
Unforgiveness.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. It's a lot of hatred.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's like having our heart healing.
So. Okay. This has just been awesome,
yes,
Pastor Harris.
Yes, yes.
On the heart.
Mm-hmm.
Does it touch some things? In me,
mm-hmm.
That the Lord had been dealing with me about. We'd like to thank you.
Amen.
For being in tune with healing the wounded heart
mm-hmm.
on today with Pastor Kathleen Harris
yes.
from New Risen Christ Ministries International.
Yes. Okay.
She is on Facebook.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yep. She's mm-hmm. on Facebook, and it's under Pastor Kathleen Harris. Thank you for viewing.
Amen, amen.
How does one describe your splendor when you're mad?